really wanted to capture the sleeping habits of people across the entire globe. So obviously there have been many smaller studies of people in laboratories, but we wanted to find out what sleep is like in the real world. How do real people sleep? How much sleep do they get? And what effect is it having on their brain?
We had 44,000 people volunteer their time to participate in our study, which was really quite amazing.
People who logged in gave us a lot of information about themselves. We had a fairly extensive questionnaire. They told us things like what medications they were on, how old they were, where they were, what sort of education they received, because these are also factors that might have contributed to some of the results. In some cases, we wanted to rule things out. In other cases, we were really interested in looking at those factors. Things like aging. Does sleep vary as you get older? And if so, what is the effect that it has on your performance?
So we found that the optimum amount of sleep to keep your brain performing its best was between 7 to 8 hours every single night. And that corresponds to what doctors will tell you need to keep your body in tip-top shape as well. We also found that people who slept more than that amount were equally as impaired as those who slept too little. I think we're all keenly aware when we don't get enough sleep, you can feel it in your body and you might feel that your brain is slightly foggy. But what we might not realize is that some of our brain functions are more impaired than others. Specifically, that our ability to solve some kind of complex everyday problem like setting the timer on your coffee maker or doing your taxes, you're not going to be able to do that as effectively if you're not getting enough sleep.
Actually, we have a lot more that we're going to do with this data, because we collected a lot of other information about people that we even haven't managed to look at yet. What we wanted to do is to pull out the main findings to find out how much sleep are people getting and how is that affecting their cognitive performance. But of course, there's lots of other factors. There's the effect of aging. Are there differences between men and women? How are people in different countries dealing with different amounts of sleep? These sorts of things. We're now going to pick apart the data that we already have. And again, this is one of the tremendous advantages of having 40,000 people respond. We have a huge data set that we can now mine to try and address some new questions that maybe have never been looked at before.